Ladies and gentlemen.
That felt good.
One gentleman in particular has come to Atlanta on three different occasions and has beaten three of Atlanta's top and most recognized fighters. He is here again tonight. Take a look at the big screen and see what the leprechaun, Roger Carroll, had to say.
The leprechaun?
I'm a fighter that does a lot of ground techniques, a lot of ground and pound, jiu-jitsu, Muay Thai, kickboxing, ground specials. I focus a lot of training on my boxing, my stand-up, and my ring control, and focusing on just being able to maintain ring control. The outcome of this fight will be with my hand raised and everybody going, holy cow, these rednecks, that again.
I'm going to contradict everything I say in my interview.
Making his way into the blue corner. Let's hear it for Roger the Leprechaun Carroll.
Hoping he's coming into some dropkick mercy.
Strike down upon thee with great vengeance and furious anger. Those who attempt to poison and destroy my brother.
What about Canover or Conover, North Carolina? Tell me about that, Lee. Newton Conover, decent wrestling team. They're always top three, top five in AAA in North Carolina. Pretty good coach, does a good job with the guys. Always real conditioned going out there to hammer some North Carolina. Tim Superior, Roger Carroll, 27 years of age, 5'10", 185 pounds, 9-4. Got his work cut out for him against 24-year-old 6'3" fighter in Tex Johnson. I mean, I understand the Irish connection, but when you decide on nicknames, what makes you decide on the leprechaun? I would at least, if I was going to fight, man, I'd be like the devil leprechaun, like Chris the devil leprechaun Fretwell or something. Man, I would be sitting here and making fun of you as well.
Better than Chris the leprechaun Fretwell.
You're right. You are correct. I'm not making fun of the guy's nickname. You just asked me. So I gave you an explanation. And you came up with the devil leprechaun. Yeah? This is like Mr. Buck Nasty.
His opponent says, I will succeed where the others have failed. I will beat Roger Carroll. Take a look at what Tex Johnson had to say.
I'm going to steal his lucky charm.
The kind of fighter that's going to bring it to you, no matter what, it's going to be hard, fast paced, just it's going to hurt no matter what happens. Whether I get knocked out or he gets knocked out, I'm going to bring the fight to you. The training I've been going through has been training with a lot of local top fighters at 185. That I think are some of the best in the States, better than where he comes from, I think, and been training
Ireland?
A lot of CrossFit,
Jim Ward.
Strength and conditioning, just trying
that's
to hold
not
up.
From Ireland, he's a leprechaun, awesome. End of a rainbow, excuse me.
Serious? Confidence in his little body, stocky style, his beating up of athletical guys.
So you're
going to
steal his monocle, please.
You know, Clint Hester, Tim Stout, it's not going to happen to me. It's gonna be him. It's gonna be him getting hurt. I'm gonna do the damage to him.
God, take his pot of gold.
Good luck.
That's what I would have said to finish off the interview, but I was really trying to put an exclamation point on it.
Making his way into the cage from Douglasville, Georgia. Put your hands together for Tex Johnson!
Perhaps I was addicted to the dark side. Somewhere inside my childhood, it makes my heart die. And even though we both came from the same places, the money and the fame made
both
us all
guys
change
coming
places.
In with that ground bounce on.
We didn't came to pass. The hard times make a true friend afraid to ask. I can't receive what you can bring
guys,
me when you need.
I
never
close to your heart to see what what come of it?
Too true. What could I do? Real wrong self, you get through. And come anew, he do the same thing if he could. It's in the hood, true homie.
Carroll coming out of
Superior.
Yeah,
the
Johnson coming out of Nestle/Alpha Fighter.
Dare
I say, is this DMX the Gang?
These broken wings.
Is that Ja Rule?
Need your hands to come
really?
And heal me once again.
Yeah, my bad.
A slack is till the end of time. These broken wings.
In the scale, all my sisters here. So you know, I don't hang around the house much. This whole night, money making got me out of touch.
Next chick to one, Carol 5-10.
Next chick
Carol Echo, the host before the fight.
Wild Bills, this is the main event of the evening. 3 5-minute professional mixed martial arts. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. He's 27 years old, standing 5 feet 10 inches tall. He weighed in at 187 pounds. With 9 victories, 4 defeats, representing Team Superior from Conover, North Carolina, Roger the Leprechaun Carroll!
Ooh, Pantera, Cowboys from Hell.
Carroll's a stand-up
man.
His opponent fighting out of the red corner.
Hey, man,
he is 24 years old, standing 6 feet, 1 inch tall. He weighed in at a trim and ready, 187 pounds. With 6 victories, only 3 defeats. Representing Knuckle Up and Alpha Fighter. From Douglasville, Georgia. Let's hear it for Tex Johnson. Referee play twice with final instructions.
I noticed that Carol has a Gracie Baja patch on his shorts. He's got a ground. He's got a brown belt and a Gracie Baja. Heavily well qualified on the ground. A lot of people throw belts around these days, but there's certain systems that demand respect if you progress through.
All right, Wild Bills, it's the main event of the evening. It's Carol versus Johnson. Make some noise!
Main event.
Johnson definitely looks like he cut a pound or two to make 187.
Yeah. Walk around weight. What's talking about, Willis?
Well, he eats right.
Tex Johnson, black trunks. These guys have identical trunks on practically. Mohawk for Johnson.
Decent jab by Johnson.
Well, they both got mohawks, so big spiky mohawk for Johnson.
And we'll go Chuck Liddell mohawk.
Oh, yeah. Liddell mohawk and spiky mohawk. Looping over right hand. Johnson catches it, tries to retaliate. Straight away single protects. He finishes in side control and then Carol immediately skates back to guard.
Johnson wants to keep it on his feet.
Scored a takedown, though, in the process.
Frello, yeah. You see some guys open-handed, some guys close-handed on their feet. What's the difference? What's the strategy with the two positions? Oh, pulling guard there. Yep. Weird wanting to be on his feet.
You know, I would say in a fight, I'm not a fan of open hands. I mean, if I'm going to punch you in the face with a closed hand, it makes sense for me to have my hands closed and ready. So I think that's just a comfort thing. Maybe somehow guys work mitts or work the bag. I mean, me personally, if I'm going to, like I said, if I'm going to hit you, my hands are going to stay closed the whole time.
Is it a Muay Thai thing? You see that in Muay Thai boxing sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's a style thing, I guess, and depending on your instructor, your coach, you know, you might take on that style, but, you know, there again, if my goal is to punch you in the face and my hand needs to be closed to do it, I might keep it closed. Oh, going knee bar here is Tex. Roger talking about his ground game in the interview, and Tex bringing a little bit of ground game of his own. Throws it by. He's got his back with no hooks. Not a lot of danger for Tex. Now he's got
both hooks in, both boots in. Tech's controlling the hand. He looks decently comfortable here, not in any real danger yet.
Only thing right here in the judge's eyes, he's going to cut that left elbow across maybe and square up and face him. Let's Carroll get right back on top. That was a little odd.
You see Carroll figure four in the body there. Oh, is that an advantage? That is tight.
I don't know what. Tex just completely bailed on all his defense there. That doesn't make any sense why he would have done that. Oh. Left his chin way up in the air as well.
He's straining a little bit.
Carroll's cranking on it. It'd be real hard to tap a guy without a completely locked up rear naked choke, but
there, it's pretty tight there.
Tex just looks
like tapping. He tapped.
Tex just putting no effort into the defense there. That kind of baffles me. Gives us a thumbs up. Like, I can't wrap my head around that. It's like as soon as Carroll got his back, he just stopped defending. I don't know what's up with that. Supposedly a brown belt in jiu-jitsu and really no defense there. Real disappointed in Texas' sense of urgency right there defending the rear naked choke. I don't understand that at all.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget about tonight.
Gave up good position. Carroll made him pay
for
it.
We'll be back on October 29th for the Halloween Wild Bills Fight Night. Mark your calendars.
All I know is win, 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 no matter what.